Gentlemen, here we are going to have a tutorial session on how to tie a tie. Majority of my mates preparing for company interviews, attending professional meetings, miss out with this technique. And so am I here today to assist you people. Now, we just draw it back in from the scratch so that we hone our skills with no room for future realignments. Am I right here? Let's just get rolling. Now, a tie has two ends. First, the broader one, and the other one, which is comparatively narrower. The broader one has to be kept almost as twice as long as the other one. Just the way I'll be telling you right here. This is the broader one, the longer one, and the other one is comparatively shorter. Now, this particular crossover has to be made counting us with the first step of the whole technique. As the second step, we must make a loop with the broader one, turning over the other. This is what it will actually look like. Mark it as you check. Third step is going to be the exact mirror copy of the second one, with looping from out to in of the knot made in lap. Fourth step marks the beginning of the climax of this whole mantra mechanism, which covers the knot as a rainbow from your left to your right, leading it all to the finisher as the broader one passes through this lately made tunnel of your tie, just the way I'm doing it. So here we go. So congratulations, gentlemen, you have successfully made your own tie way too perfect than the last time. Isn't it? Just kidding. So, make sure you have that button on. And now pull the shorter hair out to bring your knot closer to your neck. Now you have this call to me, that is, adjusting the size of your knot with that broader end of your tie, because some people prefer keeping it big and others don't. So I'll just leave this up. Set to go? Is it so? Nope. So what's left? Yes. What if the smaller end keeps on swinging around? Hang it up. Tuck it in. Simple. Simple as that. Just the way I'm doing. And this just takes her in and makes sure it won't just interrupt your looks out there when you need it to be the best in the public. And the bigger one, if you have a basket, definitely you can put it in. Right. So here, putting up the blazer. So a tip of the day that I must tell you people is what I'll be showing you here. That is, these particular margins on your left and right profiles of your collar have to be symmetric. So mind your perfection. Now, a final touch up is what it all requires, and that's it. And bang, gentlemen. Bang. Here we go with our best luck. All done. Set to go.